Hey, good morning. Happy Monday. And what a beautiful day to be alive. And here we are on this 16th year of massive draconian lies, deception, and deceit. What a real trip this is. I'm just one of those people that right from the beginning, and when I saw the towers go down, my mind just said controlled demolition. And, we're still like being buried in lies. And, I woke up this morning. I wasn't even thinking about it, really, quite honestly. And then as I was heading towards the park to take my morning walk, they were putting flags, and all of a sudden it dawned on me, like, the whole town is just covered in flags. Now, this stuff really does, I can't get behind it, that whole nationalism and patriotism, it's all horse shit in my mind, because what it does is just creates more separation, creates this whole idea that we're unified, which is just complete bullshit. And it pits us against other people, other nations. Now, here we are, it was in 2000 that Paul Wolfowitz and Donald Rumsfeld and Cheney and a mass of other people at the project, they wrote this paper called The Project for the New American Century. And it was published in 2000. And within this held all of the blueprint, the groundwork. And in the classic line that was posted in this thing is that, what we need is to create a catastrophic event, like a new Pearl Harbor. Well, there you go, folks. There was the new Pearl Harbor. We had absolutely, no evidence of planes, zero evidence of planes. No planes were found, okay? Now, get over that part. If you don't buy that, well, do more research, okay? No planes were found in Pennsylvania at the Pentagon or at the World Trade Center. Zero. And those buildings went down in a controlled demolition. And that site was cleared like it was a crime scene that was cleared with no evidence gathering done. It was just swiftly taken away, and all that steel was moved out to Staten Island and processed and put on ships and sent to China. Now, when the first responders and the people that were down there working for a long time trying to unravel that mess, there was 4 weeks, almost into months, molten steel running down beams, okay? Well, that happens in foundries, okay? That doesn't happen. And the only thing that can create the kind of heat that creates that kind of molten steel is things like thermite. Now, thermite is used in controlled demolition. It'll cut through steel like hot knife on butter. That's exactly how it works. And all the first responders, everybody was down there. They all heard explosions, lots of explosions, okay? So there's just way too much evidence to the contrary. Now, let's look at what happened almost immediately after that. Our rights were immediately just destroyed. That they had the Patriot Act already written. It was already written. It came right into the play. And then the whole system, the terrorist system, the pat-downs at the airports, the you can't fly, you can't rent cars, you can't do this, you can't do that. Everybody's now on terrorist lists and terrorist watch. Before we knew it, we were right away in Afghanistan, which we had no business being in there, except for the business we want, which, in America's history, we've been at war 222 years of our history, do the math. And, we're always after the gold, the oil and the drugs. That's God, okay? We're always fighting for God, gold, oil, or drugs. Now, in Afghanistan, the Taliban had almost eradicated the poppy fields, you know, because they're not into drugs. Well, we weren't going to have that because we control the drugs and heroin and Oxycontin. Where do you think all this stuff comes from? So, you know, now it's back up to the highest production. It's the number one producer of heroin and opiates in the whole world. And then we go into Iraq. We had no business in Iraq. You know, Somalia, Syria, Libya. You know, we went from zero to seven wars. You know, we ran out of bombs in Syria. Yeah, I mean, this is crazy stuff. So I just think it's really weird, you know, that people still can't get, I mean, I know right now, statistically, it's something like 60% of the people don't buy the official story, or it could be a lot higher than that, but more than half of the nation don't buy the official story, but we're still stuck with it. Just like we were stuck with the Warren Commission's report on the Kennedy, just like we were stuck with Timothy McVeigh for the Oklahoma City bombing. These were all lies and deceptions, big time, no different than the Gulf of Tonkin, you know, what happened at Pearl Harbor. We knew the Japanese were coming. We've been lied to forever, folks. And the reason I'm bringing all this up, well, one, it's that day, okay? But more importantly, we are now in catastrophic, cataclysmic times, you know, and it's getting worse, okay? And there is a plan to just keep depopulating. And it's the new frontier. So how are you going to survive? Okay, well, to me, I've been learning, I've been training, and I'm looking at how could I possibly survive? If, you know, when with all else, you know, if everything is being taken, how are we going to survive? Well, my answer is P, my P, because my P is free, it comes from me, and it's perfect therapy. It cures everything. It solves everything. And I can't find any reason to do anything other than that, because when you're out of food, out of water, out of money, out of time, out of luck, hey, you still got your pee, and it will heal you. So I'm just telling you, you know, we have a mission. I'm on a mission. You know, I think today I've been doing my just one meal a day fruit fast for the last 3 days running now. But now I am ready to, I think, just start a fast and, you know, cut out the fruit altogether, because I've basically been fasting anyway, because I've only been eating like this one meal a day, and it takes me about 10 minutes, 15 minutes to eat this small amount of fruit. And I'm thinking, well, I'm already fasting like 24 hours, you know, shy of 10 or 15 minutes of the day. So what's the difference? And it's not even like I'm eating because I'm hungry. So, yeah, I think today I am going to start fasting. I don't have any fruit left, so I didn't need to go buy some if I was going to eat today. And I think I'm going to forgo that. And I'm excited about that. And so it's a beautiful day to be alive. I am totally down with healing myself and others. I had a wonderful conversation yesterday with a fine woman who just started her urine therapy in August. She lives just north of where I am in a town called Grants Pass, and we're going to hook up. She's going to come down today, and we're going to share some time together. We had a good hour or some more session on the phone, and just giving her some inspirational ideas and, you know, getting her going. And that's my mission, folks. That's what I'm out here doing, is just I want to inspire people and give them ways and means to heal themselves and support them absolutely. So I'm on a mission and I'm on the road. And so if you have a desire to, you know, interface with me, hook up live, hook up on the phone, PM me on my Facebook or leave me messages in the YouTube channel or wherever, and let me know where you are, because I'll be touring all over the Southwest for the most part. And we'll see about hooking up. What do you think about that? Eh? It's a beautiful day to be alive in my world. I hope it is in your world. And so I just decided I would sit still to have this little talk this morning and face the sunshine so I don't have to see the shadows. And with all that being said, I hope you have a beautiful, wonderful, marvelous day. Remember to keep your peace together. And boom, you've just been loved. Bye now.